So URL shortener is a simple tool that takes a long URL and turns into short URL. So where are it is used to read, and it is, as it is very simple, and it is used to print in the cards and t-shirts, right? So before going into detail, I want to discuss about key things to know, right? So what is base 64? So base 64 is nothing but a characters like capital A to Z and small a to Z, 0 to 9, and any two special characters, right? So this all combination together forms a 64 characters, and these characters are used in generating the unique key. The next is key generator engine. So I want to discuss detail about key generator engine. The key generator engine is used in generating the unique ID with the help of base 64, right? So we will have a separate application which helps to build the unique characters with the help of base 64 characters, right? So we will be using that in the building the short URL. Redis cache. What is Redis cache? Redis cache is nothing but it's an in-memory database kind of a thing where you can have key value pairs. Key is something which is unique, and you can use a query and get the key and get the corresponding values, right? So load balancers. We have talked about the load balancer in the previous videos. So let's say if you have thousands of requests coming into the server and one server cannot handle it, right? In this case, we will have a load balancer in between, and the load balancer, what it does is it diverts the traffic to multiple servers to make it balanced, right? In this way, we can scale the system and we can improve the performance as well. So the next is MySQL database. MySQL database is used over here to just to store the values, right? Or the collection of records. So the next slide is what you should not answer in the interview. So if I ask a question like how do you design a URL shortener, most of the candidates come out with this diagram. So the right, as usual, they put the laptop's computer connecting to the CDN, or and from there it connects to the load balancer, and they write a couple of services like create account, create short URL, and finally they write something like Java hash table, right? If you look into this solution, technically this will work. But practically, it's not possible because you cannot scale the system, right? So keep in mind, when the questions like these kind of questions are asked, you have to write a diagram, or you have to draw the picture in such a way, right? It is a scalable system. In this, we are going to discuss about two use cases. One is unique ID generation logic, and other one is the create short URL, right? If you need more use cases, please comment and subscribe to get in future videos, right? So let's talk about what is unique ID, right? You would have seen the unique ID in multiple cases. So let me give an example with YouTube URL. If you look into any of the YouTube URL, you will have something like youtube.com/watch, a question mark, then v equal to, you will have some ID like this, right? This is a unique URL. So let's understand how this has been generated, right? So it has been generated with base 64 characters. We already talked about what base 64 character is, right? So using base 64 encoding, with one character, we can create 64 unique IDs. For example, if you take A to Z, small a to Z, and 0 to 9, with one characters, we can create 64 characters, right? Now let's say if I want to create a unique ID with two combinations, for example, A, B, A, C, A, D, etc., you can create 4096 unique IDs, right? So now, if you see into the YouTube, they have used 11 characters. So if they're using 11 characters with the multiple combinations, they can create around 73 plus quintillion unique IDs, right? So if you want to know what 73 plus quintillion unique IDs, it's enough for everyone on earth to produce video every single minute for 18,000 years, right? So technically, do you think that they will run out of the numbers? Technically, it is possible. Practically, it's not going to happen, right? So that's how they have generated the unique ID in YouTube. Similarly, we need to create a unique ID for URL shortener as well. So let's say we can use 8 characters, or typically if you see most of the URL shorteners, they are using 7 characters, right? They don't use any special characters, right? So you can use 62 characters and you can create the unique IDs, right? Okay, here is an architectural diagram, and with this we can understand how we are going to create a URL shorteners, right? So if you look over here, you have the phones or the laptops connecting to the CDN, and it connects to the load balancers. And we have three different services like create short URL, get long URL, and create account. And this can be deployed in a EC2 instance, or it can put in a Docker and you can configure to scale to the level you want, right? And here you have a Redis cache, right? The Redis cache is nothing but it's a key value pair, which we already has discussed. And we have a user table, and we have a key generator engine. Then it is and it generates the key and it puts into the database, which has key and expiration date, and other databases to store the mapping between the short URL and the long URL, which can be shared, which can be sharded based on the expiration dates. Let's talk in detail in more, right? So now let's go into each and every services, right? So create account is a simple service. Let's say you go and put all your information like your name, your company name, etc., and you create an account and it stores into the user table. Whenever you want to get a user information, you can query that and get the user information. The second thing we want to talk about is create short URL. So create short URL is like, you know, you create a short URL by passing the long URL. You can give other information if required, but primarily what you want is a long URL, right? So you call this method by, like, you know, create short URL by passing the long URL, right? So what happens here is it comes over here, right? It gets a unique key from this, and it also appends with a short domain name, like, you know, bit.ly.com or bit.ly.in/ the unique ID, right? And it creates that, and it takes that and puts into the table where you have a mapping between the ID, the short URL and the long URL, right? That's it, right? The second thing is second service which we want to talk about is get long URL, right? In order to get a long URL, we have to give the short URL, right? So come into the website, you give the short URL, right? It will generate the long URL. So how is it going to happen? So this call comes over here, right? And it goes into the Redis cache to see if the long URL exists, right? For the given short URL, do they have a long URL? Let's assume if it is not there in the first case. Now it goes into the table and it gets from the database and it brings back to the UI, right? And at the same time, it also stores into the cache, right? So next time when the same get long URL is called with the same long URL, what it is already stored in the Redis cache, and it directly fetches from the Redis cache instead of going back to the server. That's why we optimize and the performance is improved, and we don't want to query the database, right? So here I have something called lookup, right? So the lookup is primarily used to figure out which database your data is stored if you are sharding the database. Let's say if you have millions of records in a database and this database is not going to scale, right? So we have to shard at one point of time. So let's say we can shard based on the expiration date. So we already have expiration date of a key, and we can shard based on that. So this lookup can figure out based on the long URL or based on the expiration date coming over here, we can figure out at which database the data is stored, or in which database the key value mapping is over here, and exactly it goes into that table and gets that information and brings back to the long URL.